Spaghetto here, and welcome back to A Month with Natsuki. Now, I'm running on about 4 hours of sleep, so right now I have about 2.5 brain cells that are actually functioning, but I was getting tired of the cliffhanger, so I wanted to let you guys off at a better spot. Now, I apologize that I've been sick lately. I know you guys are telling me to rest, and I have. I've rested for the last couple of days. I took pretty much this whole weekend off. So I'm going to try and take it easy a little bit more in this video. And I'm excited to be mostly better. I'm still, like, pretty rough, but whatever. Let's just get into it. Just jump into it. Alright, boys. Thursday goes by incredibly slowly. I'm left with a sinking feeling in the pit of my stomach. Natsuki's been avoiding me. Why would she suddenly want to talk to me after going out of her way just to stay away from me? I hope everything's alright. As I walk up to the club room, I feel an ever-increasing sense of dread. Sayori walks up to me with her legs.
Hey, MC.
Yeah, hey, Sayori. I turn to open the door, but Sayori stands in my way.
Hey, is everything okay?
Nope. Everything is fine.
You look really worried.
Of course I'm worried. I've just had a lot on my mind lately. Oh, she's sad.
Yeah, me too.
You never read her poem.
Why don't you just go see who you came for?
Oof. Huh? Oh, jeez. Sayori's smile looks unusually forced.
As long as you're happy, I'm happy. Myself, that...
Sayori mutters something under her breath and sighs.
I'm gonna go to the bathroom. Talk to you later.
Okay. Okay, that's all you have to say? Sayori walks away. I open the door. Gosh dang it, MC. You're so freaking stupid.
She's been crying more and more lately. You don't suppose it has something to do with...
Ahem. Oh, MC, I didn't see you there. We definitely weren't talking about you or anything like that.
Are you sure?
Yuri!
Why don't I just go sit down?
Yuri is a horrible liar. Yuri darts away to a seat, promptly buries her face in a book, looking thoroughly embarrassed. Jeez, Yuri.
Anyways, are you planning on telling me what's going on between you and Natsuki?
Well, you see, her dad kinda smacks her around a little bit like a pinball, and then she came over to my house, and then we suddenly played Twister, and then she limped home. I don't know what happened. It was a wild night. I'm going to talk to her about it right now.
Really now?
Yes. I just said right now. Oh, geez.
All right, if you say so.
Monika walks over to Yuri and starts whispering something in her ear.
MC and Natsuki are totally smashing. Like, what the frick?
I mean, whatever. Natsuki is sitting by the closet and she looks anxious. She seems to be lost in thought. She's staring at her lap and whispering something. I gently squeeze her shoulder. She looks up at me and stands up.
I'm sorry.
Sorry? What for?
For the way I've been treating you the past few days.
Yeah, what the frick, whammin'?
As much as I care about you, I'm still not good at this whole communicating thing.
If you need space, you don't have to feel bad about asking or telling me.
Oh, no. That's not it at all. Being around you is the only thing that makes my life bearable anymore. You make every day better.
Then why? Brick! Why is this insufferable loli making me feel? I feel like the Grinch in the movie. He's just like, help! I'm feeling! Exit music ripped out my soul, and now it's slowly coming back. Like, what the frick? I'm actually feeling compassion again. What the heck?
When I came home Sunday, my dad...
He saw that you were walking funny and he got upset.
Yeah, actually. How did you know that?
I'm a wizard. I talked with him yesterday night.
Oh. He was crying when he came home last night.
Yes, I beat him up, Natsuki.
He was completely inconsolable. I don't know what to say or do.
Huh.
So that explains that. Because before that, he was really angry.
Aww.
But for once, it wasn't directed at me. He thought you seriously hurt me. And that's the maddest I've ever seen him get at someone else.
I mean, you were limping.
He told me that I couldn't be around you anymore if you were hurting me like that. And I just... kind of...
You're not allowed to be around him anymore because he's hurting you. Smacks Natsuki.
I mean...
Oh, she's doing the cry. No, don't be sad. Hey, it's okay. Don't be sad, please.
How is it okay?
You were scared and you didn't know what to do, and I'm not gonna hold that against you. Okay, I can't hold anything against you. I'm a noodle. I don't have arms. It's okay. She sighs.
Gosh. Between him and Sayori crying and Monika asking me all these questions, I'm wondering what's gotten into everyone. It just feels like everyone's kind of losing it, you know?
Is this why you wanted to talk to me? To vent? I mean, I'm not an air conditioner, but I can help.
No. But thank you for listening anyway.
That's what I'm here for.
After seeing him cry like that, I thought about what you said. About not hiding our relationship anymore.
And? It's time to come out of the manga closet, boys!
I don't want to be so miserable anymore. I'm so tired of avoiding the one person that makes me happy. I mean, it's not like I actually have much of a reputation to maintain anyway. I just want to be honest with myself. And the truth is that you're the only person that's ever made me feel this way.
Aww.
Screw what other people think.
Yeah.
They're just gonna keep judging me either way.
I mean, that's true.
I'm not gonna let other people decide how I should feel anymore. I'm happy with you. And that's all that matters to me.
Aww.
Besides, Monika already knows.
She told you too, huh?
Uh-huh. She keeps offering me relationship advice.
Monica's dating tip of the day, number one. If you keep him fed, he'll love you forever. Okay, everyone! It's time for another relationship tip.
And while I appreciate it, I kind of wish she'd mind her own business. But that's not the point. Do you think we could... start acting like a couple?
A couple of best friends! Yuck!
In public, I mean. Would you like that?
I would love that. I think we should be careful. I don't know if I'm ready for that. This is going so fast. I mean, we played checkers 20 minutes into the mod. I would love that, Natsuki.
Yeah, me too. Then it's settled. Starting tomorrow, you and me are gonna act like we just stepped out of the cheesiest visual novel in existence.
I thought this was the cheesiest visual novel.
Or is something like that.
You sound nervous.
Maybe I am. But tomorrow's not here yet, so I still have time to...
She exhales.
Whoa, Monica looks mad.
Huh? Monica walks over to us with her legs, looking irritated.
Is everything okay over here?
Everything's fine, Monica.
So you two aren't arguing anymore?
That's none of your business, Monica.
Excuse me?
Oh boy.
We took care of it, and that's all you need to know.
No need to be so hostile.
You're the one that told me he was manipulating me, and now you're gonna act all concerned?
Oof. Oof! Natsuki! This is a Christian server! My virgin ears! Ah!
Heck off!
Heck off!
Dang. Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez.
Let's go.
Natsuki grabs my sleeve and starts trying to pull me away. I let her mock me to the exit. Ah, oh, jeez.
We're leaving, Monica.
See you tomorrow.
Natsuki wordlessly opens the door and I follow her. That was a bit over the line, Natsuki. Come on. Natsuki, what the heck?
I'm going home. I need to be alone for a while.
Natsuki,
This isn't your fault. I just need to think.
I understand, I guess.
Don't get mad at Monica for what she said. That's between us. See you tomorrow, okay?
Yeah, see you then. Natsuki walks away. I hear faint sobbing coming from the girls' restroom. I can relate to whoever's crying in there. I'm not having the best day either. Aw, Sayori's crying. I chuckle bitterly to myself. Guess I'm walking home. Now go check on... As I walk home, I get a phone call. It's from... Sayori. I answer. Hello? Hello? Is this Pizza Hut? She hung up, must have called by accident. Jeez. This is not going well. As I approach home, I contemplate what happened today. I don't know what I'm feeling right now. Natsuki wants to be affectionate with me in public, but Monica thinks I've been manipulating her. I shake my head. Gosh, I hope tomorrow goes better than today has. Huh? A text? Are you okay? Yes, I'm fine. It's from Sayori. Are you okay? Yeah. Missed you being there. I'll be there tomorrow. Okay, see ya. I think she might have wanted to talk to me about something. Yeah, you think? Maybe I'll ask her tomorrow. Ugh. Jeez. Let's just get the day started. As I walk down the road, a familiar face greets me.
Morning!
Oh, hi Natsuki, I thought you were Sayori. Good morning, Natsuki. You feeling any better? Well, say no more.
Just shut up and walk with me.
Oh, jeez.
Come on, let's go. Let's go.
She's unusually chipper this morning. What's gotten into you?
Get mom
We're gonna be late!
there it is. There's the whammon. Natsuki and I walk to school together, chatting about our plans for the weekend. We hug each other and part ways. Aww, a woo. The second class is over, and Natsuki rushes to greet me.
Heya!
Hi, Nats. Ugh.
So, are you ready?
Ready as I'll ever be.
Alright, let's do this.
We hold hands and begin to walk to the club room. As we walk through the hallways, I feel her heartbeat in her hand. Her heart is pounding. She's either really excited or really nervous. Maybe a little bit of both. A few students laugh at us. Well, that's rude. I respond with insults of my own. She shakily opens the door. Oh, jeez. Hey, everyone!
Hey, guys!
Sayori, you look so not well. Ah, jeez.
Oh my gosh! You guys are so cute together. You mean, he's cute? I need you to find a girlfriend someday.
I'm happy for you both.
You know, it'd be nice if you'd let me say it out loud first without jumping to conclusions.
To be perfectly honest, it's been pretty obvious for a while now. Oof!
Really?
Not that I'm saying that's a bad thing. You two make a cute couple, and, I'll just go away now.
Well, this is a surprise. You're making it official, huh? Yep!
I'm happy for both of you.
Hey, Monica?
Yeah?
Sorry about what I said yesterday. I was just really frustrated.
Hey, don't sweat it. We all get angry sometimes. It happens. Just try not to do it again.
Yeah, fair enough.
Well, you two have fun together. Monica gives me a knowing look and walks over to Yuri to the console her.
Huh? That wasn't so bad.
Yeah, I think that went pretty well. Are you looking at Sayori?
And here we were, worried that something would go wrong. Guess it just goes to show that you miss all the shots that you never take, yeah?
Hmm. Yep.
You wanna go read mangoes with me?
Yeah, sure. I love mangoes.
Before you do that, can I talk to you for a second? Oh, what is it, Sayori?
Ah, jeez.
Never mind.
Sayori walks out of the club room. All right.
Hey, wait, come back.
Monica follows closely behind her. Yuri looks very anxious.
What the heck was that about?
Beats me. Yuck. We go into the hallway to see what the commotion was about.
Hey, is Sayori okay?
No, she's not. Monica is standing outside the girls' restroom. She looks concerned.
She's locked herself in one of the stalls and she won't stop crying. She won't even tell me what's wrong. What do you think's the matter?
I don't know. I'm gonna stay here and keep her company. I don't think she's coming out anytime soon. I guess you get to go home early today, huh?
No!
Sayori comes running out of the bathroom and bolts down the hallway, tears streaming down her face.
Sayori, come back! What's gotten into everybody?
I don't know! We need to go after them. Finally, MC says something I agree with. Sayori and Monica have left the building. We attempt to catch up with them, but we look outside and neither of them are anywhere to be seen. Oh, man. Natsuki and I tensely walk home. We don't say much to each other.
You think she's okay?
She didn't seem okay.
What should we do?
Let Monica handle it. Give her a phone call. Call the police! 911. It's an emergency. Best girl is crying. Please, give her some food. My gosh. I think we should let Monica handle it.
Are you sure?
No. She has experience with this kind of stuff. She'll know what to do.
Can I just stay with you tonight?
Oh.
This whole day is really starting to get to me.
Sure.
wait. I just remembered.
Huh. Remembered what?
I have a surprise for you at my house, and I need to go get it.
Oh, okay. A surprise?
Yeah. Something I bought off of Yuri.
Oh. You bought something from Yuri.
You'll see.
Okay.
I need something to take my mind off all this anyway. Let me know if you find out more about Sayori, okay?
Alright.
Love ya.
Ugh. I mean, she kisses me on the cheek and scurries off to her house. A surprise, huh? I wonder what it could be. Suddenly, my phone rings. I answer it.
I see you.
That's really creepy. Oh, that's so creepy. I look around, but I don't see anyone. Sayori? Is this a horror mod? She begins speaking in complete monotone.
Come see me. Don't bring her. We need to talk. Please.
Sayori, hi. Sayori runs past me. Man, the music in this mod is just so good. I hope she's okay. She's acting very strangely. I guess I better go talk to her. You guess? Oh my gosh, MC, you're so stupid! Alright, well that's the end of this video, I guess. So, thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe. Comment down below what you thought of this episode. I've been enjoying this mod a lot. And as always, I'll see you guys in the next one. Stay safe.